Okay, I'm back. So this same cop, man, I bullshit you not. The same girl that I was with. It's like he was stalking us. The same girl. It's like every time she would get in these rages, man, where she would just wanna fight me or destroy my things. At the time, I was like doing tattoos and I was cutting hair. So it would be her excuse to attack me, after she would do her gaslighting stuff. She would actually destroy my things, like my clippers and my tattoo stuff, so I couldn't go to cut hair because if the client was small children and their mom was a single mom. She would just automatically assume that I was sleeping with him, but this was part of gaslighting me, because she knew that this would make me highly upset, and that was a way to get me attacked by maybe her brothers or relatives or officers. But this is exactly what happened, and I remember it just like anything. This is the only thing that saved me that night. Okay, so the girl was destroying all of my stuff. I had $100 Oster clippers, Andy's clippers, all of the top pro clippers that barbers use. They cost a lot of money. And my tattoo kit wasn't very expensive, but I had a lot of pieces to it. I had several tattoo guns, a lot of different ink. My clientele was starting to pick up, and I was actually getting good at it. So this was something that I was looking forward to pursuing with my life, because I didn't have anything else going for myself at the time. And she was throwing all that stuff out in the street. And the whole time, the thought kept coming across my mind to attack her. But I had a blunt, I'm just being honest. I had a blunt and I decided to smoke my blunt and watch her from the opposite end of the apartment complex. Well, it was actually a project, the projects, and I went to the other end and I just stood down there and I watched her throw all my things out into the street and just watched all of my stuff break. And I was smoking a blunt. But this very same officer showed up behind me, once again, behind me. I always show up behind me. So he showed up behind me and I just heard his footsteps. And only thing I could think of was to crush the blood in the palm of my hand. And he knew that I was gonna do that. And he told me, "Oh man, go ahead and smoke it." But I believe he was coming to knock me out again because that thought kept coming in my head to attack her, but I didn't. Because I was like, "Man, I'm just tired of this. I'm not gonna fight her. And let her do what she wanna do, and then I'm gonna pick my shit up and leave." And that's exactly what I did. So I probably saved myself from getting kidnapped again, because he I believe they've actually done this numerous of times, But anyhow, that's one time, well, what a couple times this officer on the period. Since all of this has been going on since 97 with that one officer, all the way up until 2010, 11, and 12. I'm gonna find out his name some kind of way. If anybody knows how you can actually look up police officers in the city to find out who this guy is, because I want to know. I got an idea, but I'm just not sure. But anyhow, what else I have? Oh yeah. Well, this how another reason how I know they kidnapped me, because my phone had a video of some girl on it, some young girl, man. When I didn't realize that phone the video was on my phone till like a week later, and I was going through my phone, and it was a video in there, and I was like, okay, who is this? I don't even know this person, but they're in my phone. So they was trying to set me up then, and they also tried to kill me by injecting all those drugs into my stomach and elsewhere too, you know, and I'm just gonna be honest. I'm gonna tell y'all the truth, you know, because drug dealers, you know, they would put a crack in their rectum, you know, and that's what I used to do between the crevice of my my testicles. So, you know, I'm just being honest. I know it probably sounds gross, but that's exactly what we used to do, you know. But that day I woke up, I had drugs in my mouth and in my rectum, and I'm like, okay, I would have never even knew that this was there if I would have just went to, if I would have went to the bathroom, you know. I went to the bathroom and it fell in the toilet, you know. It's like, what the fuck? I don't even, at that time, I wasn't even selling drugs. I was just cutting hair and doing tattoos around the neighborhood. So they put that in me to, I guess, to get me to overdose. They tried to kill me, basically. You know, and I'm just being honest. This is exactly what they tried to do. They tried to kill me, you know, and I didn't die. And they've tried this over and over and over and over. Every time they try this. I've been hit with dew weapon several times. I have not died. This last time they hit me with the dew weapon, I think it was on max because I could not shake it, you know? And I went outside to put water over my head because if anybody who's been hit with a dew weapon, you know that it feels like a scream heat just hit you out of nowhere, you know? And I went outside to put a water to the water hose to, cause the temperature was cooler outside, and I said, "Well, I'm gonna put this water on my head to cool my body down," and I fell out there, and they ganged me again. I don't know if they ganged me, or they just used the remote monitor. It's like the technology is so amazing, man. Like they can attack you while they're not even there. But I feel that attack. While I was knocked out and I came to in the middle of it, and they all was gone by the time I actually came full awake. So when I came, when I was aware again, I realized that I had been jumped like never before, you know, because I was really messed up. But anyhow, they tried to kill me several times, man, you know. But I think this was police officers that did this. Yeah, because they will always be somewhere monitoring me, hiding, whether it be in an empty house, an empty apartment above mine, or an empty apartment next to mine, or somewhere close down the street. They will always do that. And I think well, I know for a fact that they will actually seduce. They will make your attitude change. They can make your attitude change to where you will actually become angry. And when you get in an outrage, this is when they do their attack on you. So, say for instance, if you get into it with someone. Like this one time, these were gang stalkers also. This street theater, everything I'm telling you. I had these neighbors, and then this one guy, he had been watching me. I need to mention, I've been keeping a weapon on me for over a year at the time. I wanted to protect myself because I was tired of getting attacked, you know? So I kept a weapon on me all the time, whether it was a knife or a gun. I kept it on me. And I didn't get attacked, but no sooner than I got rid of that gun, I got attacked again, and they made it their business to basically tell me that this is why they attacked me, because I was protecting myself. So they just want you to get fucked up out here and just die and don't even try to help yourself at all. You know, even when I started looking up about targeting, they were, hold on one second, I'm coming right back.